Hey everyone, we're here with Tony Carbone. He is a top 10 finalist of Gordon Ramsay's Master Chef, and he owns and operates the Urban Epicurean. And today we're making a risotto and then some arancini. So let's get started.
First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna get our burner going.
Awesome.
And we're gonna get this on a nice medium heat. And then we're gonna melt about 3 tablespoons of butter. We'll just give that a minute. Risotto is a great dish. I don't know how many times you've had it before, but it's a lot of people say, oh, risotto, that must be hard, that must be special. And it's kind of like the Michael Jackson song, PYT, you know, it needs a lot, it needs TLC, it needs tender loving care.
Yeah.
And you do that and it'll come out perfectly. It needs to be shown attention, you have to stir. And I mean, this is great because you can do it anywhere. You can do it, all you need is one burner and you're ready to roll, and people adore you for it. You know, you make a girl risotto, she'll be like, oh my God, he made me risotto. And not assuming that all girls sound like a 40-year-old Brooklyn woman, but. And now we got our butter melted, and we have our diced one white onion in here.
Great.
And we're gonna sit them, let them get softened up and get translucent, probably about 9 or 10 minutes.
Great.
And we'll just let that sit over medium heat. And then we'll throw a little salt in. Make sure everybody spread out evenly. And by everybody, I mean the onions. We'll let that sit and just give it an occasional stir. Well, our onions are nice and soft, so we're gonna add some of our risotto. And this is an arboreal rice. And that's actually a town in northern Italy where it comes from. And you wanna use the arboreal rice because it has a high starch content, which really gives us that nice creamy finish that we have. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna make sure we get all of this rice nice and coated with our butter and onions, and we're gonna let it just toast a little bit just to bring out a little bit of the flavor. And risotto's great to make. It's a peaceful meal if you're making it by yourself at home. And nobody asked me to plug this, but I love listening to ERS all the time, 88.9, as I'm doing my cooking. And I would say probably 70% of the music on my iPod comes from ERS.
Emerson's always of service.
All right, here we go, and we're gonna add our wine now.
Great.
And I want you to really grab the aroma that comes off of this. That's one of my favorite scents is wine when it's cooking. And
oh wow, that smells really great.
Doesn't it? It's just that some of my favorite things like that, just making like a red wine stew and I love doing that at my clients' homes because then as I'm cooking and prepping everything else, I can just smell that wine and.
Yeah. Wow.
So we're gonna let this absorb, and Atelis, you want it almost the bottom of the pan to get a little bit dry.
No, okay, right.
So now it looks pretty good, so we're gonna add some of our stock.
Cool.
And the first addition of the stock, we wanna do about 3 cups. We wanna give it a nice bath, give that risotto a chance to bathe and all of that, and it'll help soften it up. So right now, this is about, I'd say it's a 6 ounce ladle, so we'll do 3 of those. Just, we won't have to be. Exactly.
It's about right.
3 cups, yeah.
Cool. How long have you been in the cooking game?
In the cooking game, I've had my business open for a little over a year right now. Mm-hmm. I've cooked my whole life, and I worked in radio for 10 years doing the advertising sales. I managed 40 radio stations throughout New England.
Wow.
And I was climbing up that corporate ladder, the suit and tie guy. And I wasn't happy, and I said, 15 years from now, I said, I could be making $5 million a year, but I'm not going to be happy doing this. And I love to cook. It was my therapy. So I decided to call it quits in the radio game and do what I love for a living. And my wife's like, what are you doing? And I said, she's going to be really pissed that I use that voice too. So make sure you get it in there. And she was like, what do you mean? You know, you're going to quit your job. You know, we just got a place. Mm. I said, don't worry. It'll be okay. And she said, it'll be okay. It's not a plan. It'll be okay. We're good. We're good. So. And with her support and help, it's been a great first year. I knew there was going to be peaks and valleys, but it's actually really taken off. And I really have to thank my wife for it because she's been so supportive and so helpful. She does a lot of the Twittering and the Facebooking, and she's does marketing professionally.
Oh, wow, okay.
And this is kind of her little baby, and she does my website, and she rocks. I mean, it's amazing. And So we make a really good team. So
awesome.
Which is fantastic.
Yeah. Behind every great man, there's a greater woman.
Yes, there is.
So how long has the Urban Epicurean been open?
We opened in September of 2010.
Wow, so it's very young.
It's
just
very
over
young.
A year.
So yeah. we're starting to hit that first stride, and I gave myself realistic goals of saying it's going to probably take 2 years
right.
before it's a well-oiled machine.
Uh-huh.
And things it's starting to hit a little bit better now.
That's great.
And it's hard because when you look back on things, you don't have anything to compare. Like this summer was a little bit slow. Everybody's out of town.
Right.
And I didn't have anything to compare it to from the year before saying, well, what did I do this year? But now I have historical, so I know next year maybe starting in May, I'll focus my efforts towards marketing towards like Cape Cod and Nantucket. So I, you know, maybe I'll do a little cooking, go to the beach. And so my wife, that'll piss her off too, because she'll be like, your job is to go to the Cape and Nantucket for the week. So, which would be.
Sounds like a dream job to me, yeah.
All right, well, those three cups of stock absorbed them into that rice. You can see it's dried up a little bit from that big pool of broth and rice we had.
Right.
And now this is kind of dried out, so you can see, if you can see the bottom of the pan when you're kind of moving around, then you
just
know
like
it's
that.
Time to add a little bit more. And you see it in there,
yeah.
like that looks pretty dry down there. So I'm going to add another half a cup of stock. And remember, we started with about 6.5 of a combination of water and chicken stock.
Uh-huh.
We added the 3 cups for the big bath, and now we're just going to do half a cup at a time, every couple of minutes, maybe every 3 or 4 minutes.
So it's just a slow process of letting it absorb,
yeah.
but a very simple process.
Very simple process, and then we're just going to give it a stir, let it sit, and it's just, you want to keep an eye on it. You can't ignore it. It's like a newborn baby. You got to pay attention to it, and you can't turn your back because bad things happen if you don't pay attention.
Cool. So in about 10 minutes, we're going to have some ready-made risotto.
All right, it's cooked. Now we're just going to check it out. Here, I'll give you a...
Sure, thank you.
Go in there.
Wow, tastes really good. Really creamy. You can taste the broth and the wine.
And it still has a little bit of texture to it.
Yeah.
So we're going to do
Al
now...
Al dente.
All right, so we got here. Turn the heat off here. I'm going to add a little bit of salt. It still needs a little bit of something.
Cool.
And you can add salt, pepper, whatever your preference is. Right now, I'm not going to add any pepper because I don't have any white pepper. And I don't, it's a personal preference. I don't like putting black pepper in risotto milanese because it's just little black specks hanging out.
Mm-hmm.
Now I got a cup of Parmesan cheese here, so we're going to make it even creamier, add some more flavor.
Great.
We're going to mix that up here. This is done. I mean, the only thing left to do is let it eat. You want to serve it immediately because
uh-huh.
that, you know, like most foods, it's better hot. Feel free to add
wow.
more than a cup of Parmesan cheese, and there's no specific
yeah.
rule on that.
Wow. Oh, man. That's
good.
Really delicious.
See, and there's no better way to say I love you to your husband, wife, boyfriend, girlfriend. I mean, you have one pot. If you only have one burner, I just heat up some stock in the microwave and keep it in a bowl. Can you imagine that people in the hallway be like, oh, he's making risotto.
Risotto
for
in the
I mean,
dorm.
Wow. And it's just, it sounds impressive. And as we just did, it's not that hard. So
not hard, a very impressive dish.
Yeah.